For more videos, press the subscribe button and also turn on the bell notifications to receive the updates directly in your device.
Hello everyone, I Vikas Nehra welcome you all to our Nehra Classes YouTube channel. In today's tutorial, we will learn how to create and manage the partitions on GPT disks in Linux. But before I show you the procedure of creating or managing the partitions on GPT disks, we must know the difference between the GPT disk and the MBR disk, as well as we must know what are the limitations of the MBR disk. As you know that in Linux, we generally use the MBR disks and we manage the partitions by using the fdisk command there. But there are certain limitations of MBR disks, like we can only create up to 4 primary partitions there, and MBR can only support the disks up to 2 TB. So these are the two major limitations of the MBR disks. And if we need to create more than 4 primary partitions, or if we are going to use the disk of more than 2 terabyte in size, then we will go for the GPT. GPT stands for GUID partition table, and it can support up to 128 partitions. So that is we are going to learn in this tutorial. So without wasting time, let's get started. So this is the machine which is running on CentOS, and on this machine I have 2 additional disks, SDB and SDC. These disks we are going to use for today's tutorial. To create or manage the partitions on the GPT disks, we use the gdisk command. And this command can also list the details of the disks. So if I want to list the details of the SDB disk, I can mention gdisk-l and the disk name, that is /dev/SDB. So you can see that it is a raw disk. There are currently no partitions present on this disk and the size is 10 GB. Now I will show you how can we create more than 4 partitions on this disk by using the gdisk command. So we can write gdisk /dev/SDB. So after gdisk, we have to mention the name of the disk where we want to create the partitions. Press enter. After that, it will prompt you. If you don't know, you can press question mark for the help. And here you can see the details of the commands that we can use in this utility. To create the new partition, you can simply press N here, because N is used to create a new partition. Press enter. After that, you have to define the partition number. So I'm going to create the first partition. I will write here 1. After that, you have to define the first sector. I will go with the default one, 2048. Then you have to mention the size in KB, MB, GB or TB. I want to create a partition of 1 GB, so I will write here +1G, press enter. And after that, it will ask you for the hex code. And by default, the hex code for Linux is 8300. If you don't know the hex codes, you can print them by pressing capital L. Here you can see the details of these codes. So I will go with the default one, 8300, press enter. So it will select Linux file system for 8300. And after that, if you want to save the changes, press W and press enter. So it is saying final checks are complete, about to write the GPT data. Here you have to press Y and press enter. So it will create the partition on the disk. Now, if you want to see the details of the partitions, you can again execute gdisk-l command. And this time, you can see the partition there. So, partition of 1 GB, we have created there on this disk. And this is the GPT partition table. You can also execute the lsblk command. It will show you the details of the partitions on each and every disk. So, the partition of 1 GB is visible there. Now, I will show you how can we create more than 4 partitions. So again, we will execute the same command, gdisk /dev/SDB, and for new partition number 2, we will go with the default size and we will create a partition of 1 GB again. Again, we will go with the default hex code 8300. One more partition we are going to create, partition number 3. We will go with the default size. Again, we want to create a partition of 2GB this time. So we will write there plus 2G, press enter. For hex code, we will go with the default one, 8300. And after that, we will create one more, partition number 4. Default size, the total size 1GB, hex code 8300. And after that, we will press W. So you can see that we have successfully created 4 partitions on the SDB disk, and we can list them by running the lsblk command. And here on this disk, we can create 124 more partitions because this is using the GPT partition table. Let me show you the details of this disk by running the gdisk-l command. And here you can see the details of the partitions. 4 partitions are there. Now let me create 2 more. So again, we are going to use the gdisk command. And for new partition number 5, we will go with the default size. One more partition we are going to create of 2GB here. The hex code would be 8300 for Linux file system. And one more we are going to create. So you can see that it is saying this is the 6th partition and total 128 are available. So we can create up to 128 primary partitions on GPT disk. So that is the beauty of GPT disk. So we'll go with the default one. This time we are going to use the entire size which is available. And again, hex code 8300. And we will write the changes by pressing W there. And we will proceed with capital Y and press enter. And we are done. So we have created 6 primary partitions in total on this disk. So this is possible because we are using the GPT partition table on this disk. If we would have used the MBR disk, we could have created only up to 4 primary partitions or 3 primary, 1 extended partition. But here we can create up to 128 primary partitions on this disk if we are using the GPT disk or the GPT partition table. Now, if you want to use these partitions to keep the data, you have to format them. So I'm going to format the first partition as ext4. So I will execute mkfs.ext4/dev/sdb1. So this will be formatted as XFS. So this is formatted as ext4 and UUID has been generated against the same. Now we can create a directory which we will mount on this partition. So let me create it on SRV with the name as test1. And after that, we are going to mount it on /dev/sdb1. And after that, we can use it to save our data. So let's go to SRV/test1 directory, and there we can create the files. And to see the details of the mounted file systems, we can execute df-h command. So the directory is mounted and the file system is ext4, and this is using the GUID partition table. If you want to create the LVM, you can also do that. So for creating the LVM, you have to create the physical volume first. After that, you have to create the volume group, and then you can create the LVM. So we are going to use the partition number 2 for that. So let me execute pvcreate command, pvcreate /dev/sdb2. After that, we will create the volume group. So we will execute vgcreate. This time I will mention here gpt vol group, and I will mention the name of the partition or the physical volume, that is /dev/sdb2. And after that, we will create the LVM. So we will execute lvcreate -L. Then we will mention the size. So let me mention the size as 1000 MB. Then we will write there -n, and we will mention the name as gpt lvm, and after that we can mention the volume group name. Now we will check the details of LVM by running the lvs command. Here you can see that LVM of 1GB is available. We will also check the details of the volume groups by running the VGS command. So you can see that the volume group is present. And to check the details of the physical volumes, we can execute the PVS command as well. So this is visible there. In case if you want to use it, you can format it. So I'm going to format it as XFS. So we can execute mkfs.xfs/dev/gptvolgroup/gptlvm. So this will be formatted as XFS, and we can see the file systems by running lsblk-f command. So you can see that LVM is present on this partition and the file system type is XFS. Now we can create a directory on SRV with the name as test2 and we will mount it there. So let's execute the mount command. mount /dev/gptvolgroup/gptlvm, and the path is /srv/test2. Now we will go to /srv/test2 and we can create the files there. Let me create few files. To see the details of the mounted file systems, we can execute df-h command. So you can see that we are able to create the LVM on this partition, which we created by using the gdisk command, or we are using the GUID partition table. So we can either use these partitions physically, or we can create the LVMs as well as per the requirement. But there are certain conditions which you must know if you want to use the GUID partition table or GPT. If you want to use GPT, your motherboard should have UEFI. So UEFI should be present and enabled in BIOS in your machine if you want to use the GPT. If your motherboard does not support UEFI, in that case you have to stick with MBR only. For simple BIOS systems, we can use the MBR disks only. And for GPT partitions, either you can use the gdisk command in Linux, or you can use the parted command as well. I will show you how can you create or manage the partitions using the parted command on Linux in the next tutorial. And for the MBR disks, you already know that we use the fdisk command to create or manage the partitions. So guys, that's it from my side for today's session. I hope you would have enjoyed the session. If you like it, then do share it with your friends and colleagues and give a like to this video. And if you are new on this channel, then please subscribe us and turn on the bell notification. I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye. Jai Hind, Vande Mataram, take care.